Hey YouTube, so what I'm doing right now, I'm going to cornrow this side here, then wash the rest, and then twist this side. I like to do my cornrows on dry hair just because it works better for me. My hair doesn't get tangled in my cornrows, so that's what's going down. So I'm just gonna, let's see, do a part down this way. Let's see, let me bring it all that way. Part down that way, and then part going back up, and then I'm only going to do one cornrow video. You guys have seen 100 million videos about cornrows, I'm sure. So then I'll show you once it's all done, and then before I get to the twisting part, so after I've washed it. So let me get that in. Cool. Put my clips on. What I'm putting on my hair to cornrow, which is what I put on the little girl's hair when I cornrow it. I have this mixture that I made of shea butter, coconut oil, and olive oil. So I used, I would say probably like a cup of shea butter to maybe a quarter cup of coconut oil and like 2 tablespoons of olive oil. It doesn't make it extremely wet or whatever, or like liquidy, but if you want to see, you know, it's good enough that it doesn't take me long to rub it in my hands and get it heated up. So once I put that, rub that in my hands good, put that on, then I use, yes, I use the black gel. The Pro Style and Pro Protein Styling Gel, Super Hold, blah, blah, blah. But it's alcohol free. It does not flake and it lets me catch some of those small hairs. So I just put a little bit on the back of my hand so that way, as I'm grabbing the hair and cornrowing, then I can actually grab a little more gel off the back of my hand and don't have to reach down into the jar. I don't know if you can see, probably not the best way for me to show you the cornrow action. See, that's how I grab a little more gel as I'm cornrowing. So I'm hoping this style will last a little while. It got cold real quick, and so I'm not really a fan of, you know, having a wet and go style, wash and go, whatever, too often, because it's too cold for all that mess. So cornrow. Yep. Okay, probably not the neatest, but it's good enough. I do way better on other people's heads than I do on my own. But okay, so that's just one cornrow, and I'll keep, you know, going around like that. So I'll show you once this part gets done and once I wash the other side. So I'll be back. Okay, so I finished braiding. Not that neat, because I really can't do it too neat on my head. Once I put some gel on it, tie it down, it won't be that bad. Next, I'm about to finish. See, I already started twisting. So what I use, Silky Milk by Straight Request. You can only order online. I heard about it from my hairdresser. I've used it for years. Love, love, love this setting lotion. It works better in a foam, like a pump bottle. So I always just buy a bottle and empty out the contents. Also, I mix oil inside of my setting lotion when I use it. So I use about a sixth of the full size bottle. Shake it up. This time I use the Carol's Daughter Tui Hair Oil because I already had it and it smells good. And it just allows me to have that moisture already in my twist. So that way, once I take the twist out, I don't have to manipulate them too much and then they get fuzzy and all that good stuff, or bad stuff rather. So I'm gonna part this. I lied in my earlier video when I said I was gonna like wash or co-wash the other part of my hair and twist it. I lied because it's cold where I am. And it's not gonna be dry by in the morning. So, excuse me. So what I'm gonna do is just twist, and what I'll first do is put the setting lotion on, and it has some water content to it. So what ends up happening is it will draw up. So I'll put this on, walk around for about 2 minutes, kind of let it penetrate, again, using the foam bottle, shaking it up with that oil in it. And I use a good amount because, like I've said probably in a previous video, I'm heavy-handed with product. I like to know it's on there. So you see it goes on. It's kind of soapy. This set lotion does not dry your hair out. It leaves it very soft, moisturized, but still you get a defined twist or curl or whatever it is you're using it for. My stylist, she only uses this on natural hair. She uses other setting lotions on her perm clients. So you see it's starting to wave up a little bit. Get on the ends there good. Kind of do all this number here. Then I'm going to show you a section and how I do my twists. Get a pretty good size section. Okay. So, make sure I get it good in the root. So just stick my finger down the middle. Take the hair and I twist. You see how I turn my finger under? So what it's doing is kind of turning this hair around. So, finger under like that, finger under like that, twist and finger under. Okay, so once I have them apart, then I take this index finger, move it around, and it kind of rolls that hair around as I do it. So I do it all the way down. If I get a little too much foam going, just kind of pull it, put it on the ends. Alright, so once I get towards the end, I don't twist my hair to the very tip, okay? Let me tell you why, because when you take it out, it'll spiral straight instead of stand. So what I do is leave the end out and I just coil that around my finger. So if you have hair that has any type of coil to it, then you can do that. Just roll it around the finger like that. Okay. So I'll see you back. Hopefully it'll be dry by in the morning. If not, I'll be going to work like this. They know me for having craziness going on with my head, so they'll be all right. You see, I've already got half my routine done this morning when I had squirrels into my jeans. You know how that goes. Don't worry, I'm wearing a long shirt, so nobody will see all the extraness going on behind me. Anyway, so I'm just gonna unravel these. What I do is I pull them apart, just unravel them all the way over and then go back and see how much I want to actually, you know, pull them apart again. And you see how my ends are, you know, still curled up instead of, you know, twisted straight because I coil them around my fingers instead of twisting to the very end. So, and usually what I sometimes do is like the first day I wear it just to make it last longer, I just pull it apart once. And then the next day I pull it apart a little more. And then after that, depending on what it looks like, then I may like have to do big twists in it at night, which I also learned from Miss Pretty Depend. Thanks much, girl. So I don't care. All right, pull that one out. Let me turn back around. Is that it? Yep, that's it. So yeah, I think this is that big wet one. So you see, got a nice little wave action to it. The part at the top that was braided didn't really do anything. And like I said, this part is wet. So I'll probably still tie it down in the car. It's still dark outside. I wonder if I see me with my scarf on in the car, you know what I'm saying? Anyway, so that's it. I'm gonna leave it like this for today. There's one. And then I'll pull it apart more tomorrow, probably, and let it get bigger as the week goes by. Because I'm trying not to be in my hair every other day, but I obviously, as you can tell, I have a problem with touching my hair and doing something to it every couple of days. So, that's it. Stay tuned for the pictures. What I'll do is I won't post this until I take pictures after I pulled it out so you can see it like this. And then also see it after it's pulled out.